Bono did not say Donald Trump is destroying America, despite claim. Bono has not been shy about criticizing Donald Trump, but he never said the president is destroying America. The website known for spreading fake news is combining real quotes from the musician with fake ones. Gossip cop can bust the deception. Last week, Rolling Stone published a new interview with Bono times to the recent release of U2's latest album, Songs with Experience. During the wide-ranging chat, which was conducted by publisher Jen Wenner himself, the Irish frontman spoke about how the current state of politics has affected his view of humanity and influenced his new music. He said, for example, when the 2016 election happened and people intuited that something awful and something unprecedented was happening, there was a sense of grief. We had Brexit, so people in Europe are feeling this as well. And I thought, this is melodrama. Why are people, rational people I know, feeling like they are grieving like someone just died? It is an election, and it will correct itself, whatever, Bono said. But then I realized that something had died. People's innocence had died. Now Neon Nettle is using the interview for an article headlined, Bono, Donald Trump is destroying America, we must stop him. The site claims, Irish hawker of U2 colludes with elite remove president, but he never actually said Trump is destroying America, nor did he talk about removing him from office. The outlet rightly notes that Bono called this bleakest era since Nixon, but goes on to falsely claim he said, Donald Trump is destroying America, we must stop him. He's destroying the America that I loved, the country that allowed me to be involved in politics. Those alleged quotes do not appear anywhere in a Rolling Stone interview, and no reputable outlet has reported Bono saying those statements. In fact, a cursory Google search shows they originated with Neon Nettle itself. The online publication is deceptively presenting a collection of Bono's real comments mixed with fake ones. And its headline is based on one of those fabricated lines. The end of the article also contains a glaring misrepresentation, with it asserted, back in January this year U2 announced in an interview that they were going on strike to protest Trump, by canceling their upcoming album release and tour until the president-elect resigns. Looks like that didn't work out. In actuality, the band was never on strike and continued touring throughout 2017. And U2 chose to delay the new album both to address Trump's presidency and to deal with personal problems, including health issues. The site is presenting an unsubstantiated version of events to fit a fake news narrative.